Today I'm going to talk to you about the PCOS hacks that I used that actually worked and helped me lose 50 pounds in 3 months. When I got diagnosed with PCOS in my mid-20s, I was struggling so much. My PCOS symptoms were through the roof. I was at my heaviest of 275 pounds, and my PCOS symptoms were so bad, especially the hair thinning that you get that acts sort of like male pattern baldness, where my hair was thinning and I was losing a ton of hair, to the point where one day I was freaking out in the shower washing my hair. I was washing it and I was pulling handfuls of hair, and I ended up spreading it all over my shower, and I was like, oh my gosh, something is really wrong. So I gathered it up, I put it in a plastic bag, a Ziploc bag, and I brought it to the doctor. And I was like, this is the amount of hair coming off in my hands every day in the shower. Something is wrong. And the doctor just went. So I was like, okay, I gotta figure this out. So I went through several doctors and I realized I had PCOS. They offered some medications, but when I checked out all the medications, it was all these bad side effects that I didn't want. So I went and I bought a book on PCOS, and I heard really good reviews, and I was like, okay, this is gonna help me. I'm finally gonna figure this out. There were a couple things the book said. Your PCOS symptoms will get better if you lose weight, and medication, but I didn't want to try medication because there was too many side effects. And then it said, try low glycemic foods. First of all, I tried all the other diets. I tried taking away certain food groups. I tried all the diets recommended in the book. I tried all the fad diets, but nothing was working. It always ended up in failure. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna give this low glycemic food thing a try because it's supposed to help. So I went to the grocery store and I bought every low glycemic food you could ever possibly find. Sweet potato. They said that potatoes were okay, but the red skin ones were lower glycemic. I bought oatmeal. I bought omega-3 fish oil because they said that would help. And I ate it all. And you know, it did help a little bit, but it kept leaving my stomach distended, like all of the foods, especially sweet potato. And they said that is so good for PCOS. And I was like, is something wrong with me? Because these foods are just making me feel bloated. The thing is, with PCOS, you already hold belly fat, and it's really difficult to lose weight. And that was the one thing when I got diagnosed, they were like, you have PCOS, and in order to make the symptoms better, you have to lose weight, but it's impossible to lose weight with PCOS. So I like walked away and I was like, what do I do with this? It's also pushed in the media that you're not gonna be able to lose belly fat or weight with PCOS. Everybody pretty much pushes, this is impossible. So I walked away with, I got this thing that you can't cure, that you can't lose belly fat, which I hold a lot of, and you have to lose weight to make the symptoms better, but it's really hard to lose weight. So the low glycemic foods didn't work. I had all these embarrassing things. Not only was my hair thinning and I was starting to get like patches of missing, like of bald spots on my head at 28 years old, you get really dark patches of skin in the groin area, under your armpits, under your chest area, to the point where I was so embarrassed in the summer to wear tank tops because if I lifted my arms, you could see these dark patches. They were really bad. The hair, you don't get hair on your head. You get body hair growth everywhere that you don't want it. To the point where I'd have to shave, I still do every day. As soon as I was done shaving, the hair was growing back. I finally was like, okay, these low glycemic foods aren't working, but I heard that eating high fiber foods are really good. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna eat what I like, but I'm gonna choose lower calorie, higher fiber foods. So I started eating spinach and berries, but also eating things that I liked. Like I loved pizza, I loved ice cream. So I was choosing lower calorie versions of all of my favorite foods, but making sure that my day had a lot of fiber in it, and I was eating low calorie food that I could eat a lot of. And then I also heard that exercise was really good for PCOS. But because it was so heavy, I was 275 pounds, I couldn't really do much. So I started walking a little bit every single day. Portioning out my food, combined with eating lower calorie and moving my body every day, I went into a calorie deficit and I started losing weight. Some of my favorite berries, I liked mixed berries, I liked raspberries, blueberries, strawberries. Those are all really low calorie and you can eat a lot of them, and they're very high in fiber and lower in sugar. Eating lower in sugar is also something that really helps PCOS, so I tried to choose things that were lower in sugar all the time, and berries did everything that I was looking for. Also baby spinach, because I could eat a lot of that for lower calories, and it was really versatile. So I could make it taste good and put it on anything, including my pizza. So doing that, I started to lose weight. And because I had so much weight to lose, and I went from eating a ton of food to portioning everything out every day and moving my body a little bit, I lost 50 pounds in 3 months. I dropped the weight really quick. And after I lost those first 50 pounds, it was like a miracle. The dark patches on my skin faded. Now they're just very, very faint. I can see them, but no one else can. All the body hair, it slowed. It still grows really fast, but that's a part of PCOS that will never go away. I was told it was impossible to get a flat belly with PCOS. I have lost a ton. My belly has gone down massively. Now, I still carry a little bit in my belly, and I don't think that will ever go away just because that's what PCOS does, but it is possible to get a fairly flat stomach because I have done it. I went to my doctor, I was having really bad acne, and even losing weight wasn't helping. So he put me on some birth control, which was specifically meant for helping people with acne. It's called tricyclin 21. And that massively helped my acne, because the acne was actually really painful. It was like constant. So that, like, my skin, you can see now, it's like pretty clear. And it's because of eating properly, losing weight, and the birth control. And then I discovered biotin.
That you have in your pocket. Did you know we were filming this video or something?
No, I just carried it around in my pocket. Okay, so this is biotin. I buy the 10,000 mcgs. It says it promotes hair growth, healthy skin, nails, hair. You also get brittle nails with PCOS. That's one thing that I haven't really found a help for yet. I take one of those 10,000 mcg capsules every single day after I eat breakfast, and it has actually cut the amount of hair that I lose in half every day. I still pull away a lot of hair when I wash my hair, but it's way, way less than it used to be. So the friends, those are some of the tips and tricks that I use to help me lose weight and to help reduce some of my PCOS symptoms. I hope there is hope. Just know, if you have a diagnosis or recently got diagnosed, you are not alone, and it's not impossible. You can reduce the symptoms. I am here. Leave a comment down below. You're not alone, ladies. I hope this helps. Love you. Check out some of the tips. Wiggle, wiggle. If you want to know exactly what I ate to lose my first and next 50 pounds, I have 2 weight loss guides in the link down below.
And these boots were made for walking.
Yes, these boots was made for walking. Biotin in my pocket. Let's shake and wiggle all day. And one, my love. Watch these 2 videos. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Tell your mom I make it. Love you. Peace. I'm out. Remember the friends that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it.